La Bible dit
every curse,
toute curse, malédiction,
without a cause,
sans cause,
it will not work.
Et sans effet.
But if what if there is a curse?
Kasi soki malédiction sans cause nango.
Alléluia.
Amen.
What if there is a cause?
Kasi soki malédiction sans cause.
Because many times we say God, it is without effect, sans effet. But when there is a cause, kasi it will affect.
Soki sans cause.
And that's why Jesus said,
Yesu alobi,
do not give access. So that access is a door. Because Jesus said,
Yesu alobi,
the prince of this world,
le prince de ce monde,
the prince of this world,
le prince de ce monde,
he came to me.
Il est venu vers moi.
When he came to me,
tant voyait pas en angai,
he find nothing.
Amoni eloko teo ya ye.
Let me tell you something.
Tikara yebisari.
If the prince of this world,
soki prince ya mondo oyo,
he came to Jesus,
aye pai na nkolo Yesu,
it means he will also come to you.
Alobi eleko lakisenga. Kipego ye pai na yo.
It means he will also come to you.
Eleko lakisako. Kipego ye pai na yo.
Jesus said,
Yesu alobi,
he came to me.
Prince mondo aye pai na ngai.
In me,
kasi na ngai,
there was nothing.
Satan amoni eloko te.
Is the problem today?
The one problem, Lelo,
that in the churches,
Naba Iglesia,
we are praying,
tozaliko bonde,
we are shouting,
tozaliko yemba,
we are dancing,
tozaliko bina.
But the prince of this world, when he comes,
kasi Satan utangwa ye,
he finds things that belongs to him.
Amoni biloko na ebele bele na bomo ina yo.
Oh, you don't say amen, huh?
Oh, amen.
So what are the access doors?
Baporte ya mwezali nini?
Write this down.
Tetoko maboya.
Ephesians chapter 4 verse 26.
Ephesians 5.
Ephesians chapter 4.
Et Ephesians 4 en 4.
Ephesians 4 26 and 27.
Ephesians 4 26 27.
We are going to read Ephesians chapter 4.
Nous allons lire Ephesians 4
verse 26 and 27.
Verset 26 et 27.
These are the doors. I'm talking about the access door. Let us begin to read verse 26. This is what the Bible says.
Ephésiens 4, 26, je lis au nom de Jésus.
Si
vous vous mettez en colère, ne péchez point. Que le soleil ne se couche pas sur votre colère. Et ne vous donnez, ne donnez pas accès au diable.
The Bible says, if you are in anger,
la Bible dit, soki mozali na kanda,
do not let the sun go down in your anger.
Kokende kolala te ntango za na kanda.
Because do not give access to the enemy.
Eboye kopesa accès te na diable.
The first access point, write it down.
Le premier point d'accès to komi yango.
That gives access to the enemy and to the incubus and evil spirit in your life.
Et loge pesa accès au diable pe pesa accès na esprit incubé succube na bomoi na biso.
It is anger.
Ezali kanda.
It is anger.
La colère, kanda.
Some people you come to church.
Batu mingi yo yaka na eklesia.
There are some people even in the same church.
Eh, batu mususu peka na kati eklesia oyo.
You don't talk to each other.
Yo kuto onlobi saka bangote.
There are some people you are so angry.
There are batu mususu bazali soko tali eka kenlongo kangi.
You are anger in your heart.
Tali muteme komi kanda kanda.
There are some people you are a Christian.
Batu mususu zape namo Kristu.
You say I will never talk to that person. Before I talk to them,
avant ana lobo sabango,
they have to ask me another finger.
Koma bagisa musapi moka mukie.
You gonna look like a monster, right?
Eh, obozela lokola diabolo ko.
Now listen to me.
Yo kanga malamu.
You laughing?
Ozoseka.
But do you know?
Kasi oyebi.
That these are the things.
Biloko oyo mususu.
These are the things.
Biloko oyo kopuse kopesa.
These are the things. These are the things that has, is hindering you. The anger in your heart.
La colère dans ton cœur.
The anger towards your husband.
La colère envers ton mari.
The anger towards your wife.
Anger
towards people even in the city.
La colère même envers les gens dans ce pays.
Listen, the Bible says.
La Bible dit.
He said, do not let the sun go down in your anger.
Que le soleil ne se couche pas sur votre colère.
What does that mean? Never go to bed.
Jamais kokende kolala
with anger.
Tango zana kanda.
Many marriage.
But mariage belé.
They receive the incubus or succubus because of this point.
Milimo ya incubus na succubus yaka na bomoi na libote na bango pona makambo.
Because when you are married,
so kimo balali,
and you going to bed,
et vous allez dormir la nuit,
and you are angry,
et puis vous êtes en colère,
you turn this way.
Mon papa baluka pe mokomo, mama baluka pe.
The wife turned the other way.
Mama taline kota mil.
When the spirit comes,
si kotamo milimo incubus na succubus yaka.
They see in the bed,
et fatali na mbeto,
there is a space. You
give
them access.
That
is where the access comes in marriage. You are married, never go to bed angry. You are in the bedroom, your husband is in the couch. These are access points. That's why many people are suffering today. When you give this access, the spirit they come. That's what the Bible says. Never go to bed. Don't allow the sun to go down in your
cave.
Never go to bed angry. This is the first point. The second point is this. But the Lord began to reveal to me, there are many people that are suffering because of this. The spirit of
rejection.
If you have rejection, you feel rejected, you have to deal with this. Because when you are dealing with the spirit of rejection, you make yourself vulnerable to the evil spirit.
Tu te fais vulnérable aux esprits impurs.
Everybody who deals with rejection,
toute personne qui combat avec cet esprit de rejet,
they have a problem with people that really love them.
Ils ont un problème avec les gens qui leur montrent un amour pur, un amour sincère.
Man or woman that has a spirit of rejection. When you begin to love them, you begin to show them pure love, they will push you, they will run away from you. Why? Because in them,
parce que en eux,
there is a spirit of rejection.
Y a un esprit de rejet.
So they are expecting to be rejected.
Ils s'attendent à ce qu'ils soient rejetés.
So they can never accept pure love.
Et ben moi, jamais ma nima kabo lingua solo.
And many people, they are married, but they are dealing with the spirit
et
of rejection.
Et batubele lelo babala na bango kasi esprit a rejet. Ils sakana na
kaka. I say the Lord will set you free.
Na nzamba kotkomi se libre.
I declare the Lord will set you free.
Nzamba kambo na yo.
So when you are suffering from rejection, you have to deal with it. The man of God is here, the woman of God is here. You need to talk about it so that you receive deliverance and freedom from rejection. Another thing the Lord was revealing to me, I have to explain this. The Lord said to me,
le Seigneur m'a dit,
many people have opened the access to the enemy.
Beaucoup de gens ont donné accès au diable.
And the spirit of incubus and succubus is dealing with them, especially women.
Et le mauvais esprit d'incubus et succubus est en train de les contrôler, particulièrement les femmes.
It is dressing and looking sexy.
Et Zali Kolata, peut pas mon aosa sexy. J'ai pas mon cousin et l'ambe kamanzot.
The Lord said to me, dressing and looking sexy.
Listen to me.
There is a difference between beautiful
entre kozala kitoko
and being sexy.
Et kozala sexy.
The Bible never said,
la Bible n'a jamais dit,
that the women in the Bible, they were sexy, they were beautiful.
Que basi na Bible wazalaki sexy, tete wazalaki kitoko.
The Bible said that Esther was beautiful.
La Bible dit qu'Esther était très belle.
Sarah was beautiful.
Sarah était très très belle.
Rachel was beautiful.
Rachel était très belle.
But they were never sexy.
Et ces femmes n'étaient pas sexy.
out to the kingdom of darkness, to incubus and succubus, that you are available. You are walking on the street and men look at you. They say, oh my sister,
oh my sir,
you are sexy.
Oza sexy.
You have to turn around.
You
have to tell them, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible don't say you have to look sexy.
Parce que la Bible ne dit pas que tu dois être sexy.
Some of you, you go to your Facebook.
Beaucoup de gens ici, vous allez sur Facebook.
You put pictures.
Botaka ba photo.
Like this.
Obimisa lo lemo.
You put picture.
Obimisa lo step photo.
You turn it like this.
Bokongo nyoso libanda.
What are you showing?
Ozo lakisa nini?
Some of you, you wear pants. You wear pants.
Olati.
It is written sexy.
Ah, merci ma pantalon ma commis sex.
So when you are walking,
tamozo tambola,
and it's written in pink.
Eba kumia mona couleur rose.
It attracts everybody's eyes there.
Nyoso ho ezali ku miso batozo kende kana na equipe.
So when you dress like that,
tobo latin nengo wana,
are you evangelizing?
Yozo si kozo sala evangelisation.
Can I preach like a Phoenix? You see, and now you come to church.
So now, oh, you're in the église.
Oh, this feels. It is not going to work.
No, it got to marcher.
And that is the problem.
C'est ça maintenant le problème.
Many women, you come to church.
Beaucoup de dames, de femmes qui viennent à l'église.
You go out, you wear the Phoenix.
Oh, la dit que. T-shirt,
you
have
faith. You expose your whole body now. But the Bible says,
la Bible dit,
your body is for your husband.
Ton corps est pour ton mari.
When you dress like that,
so, it means
you are available for everybody, including evil spirits. Because this spirit, they are looking for sexual relations. So when you make yourself available,
am I helping
somebody? You put pictures on your
Facebook.
You put like this. You sit on the couch. And people write sexy.
Ah, but you know about commenter,
and sexy. You yourself, you write, I am hot.
You are
hot in what? But now listen to me. You, these are the problems. And then you think, you know, maybe my grandfather was a witch.
And
it's not grandfather, it is
you.
Listen to me. The Bible says,
la Bible dit,
in the book of Genesis chapter 6,
dans le livre de Genèse au 6e chapitre,
that Bible, we're not reading, we have no time.
On ne va pas lire ça.
Genesis chapter 6,
Genèse 6,
that when the women,
dans au basi,
they were extremely beautiful. The Bible says,
la Bible dit,
that spirits,
by spirit,
the angels,
by angels,
that were sent,
les anges déchus,
they looked at the women,
by talibasio,
they were extremely beautiful. It pushed them.
Et tindi ba milima ange déchu.
To have sex with them.
Pour te balala na bango.
When you begin to expose yourself, you become available even to spirits. And you make yourself available.
Et tu te fais disponible.
And this spirit comes and they torment people's lives. Another thing the Lord was ministering to me is an access point.
Is a point d'accès.
It's an open door.
Is a porte effondrement.
The Lord said to me,
la, le Seigneur m'a dit,
it is masturbation.
C'est la masturbation.
Can I preach like a fit?
Est-ce que je peux prêcher comme je veux bien?
I came to help somebody.
Je suis venu aider quelqu'un.
The Lord said to me, masturbation.
Le Seigneur m'a parlé de la masturbation.
Masturbation is an open door.
La masturbation est une porte grandement ouverte.
Let me tell the young people at school, they say it is science and biography. It is not biography.
Laissez-moi parler aux jeunes gens à l'école. On nous dit, oh ben c'est la science, c'est la biologie. Non, c'est
pas
la biologie.
People go to sleep and you dream sexual dreams.
Bah, tu vas la yo, zolote faka bandoto ya sex, ya sex.
At school you are 10, 11, 14. They say it is the pubertate level. So to have those dreams. It's
normal.
The age of 12, 13. But you are like 15, 35. Which age are you now? You are not more in that age. It's
normal.
The age you are, you cannot have that things anymore. It shows that there is a satanic presence. The Lord said to me, many people have opened the access door because of masturbation.
Le Seigneur m'a dit que beaucoup de gens ont ouvert leurs portes à cause de la masturbation.
Because many people don't understand.
Parce que beaucoup de gens comprennent pas.
That sexual relationship.
Les relations sexuelles.
Is not only enjoyment.
Exactamente es sengo.
Sexual relationship.
Relation sexuelle.
It was meant to unite people.
Et pour essanguer sabato.
And the only holy way of pleasing the Lord is to marital relationship. Because sexual relationship, it unites people.
Parce que les relations sexuelles,
it brings the unitement.
Ça unit, ça fait que les gens soient ensemble.
So the Lord said, when people engage in masturbation.
Et le Seigneur m'a dit, quand les gens se donnent à la masturbation.
Write this down.
Écrivez ceci.
When somebody engages in masturbation.
Quand quelqu'un se donne à la masturbation.
You access the spiritual dimension.
Tu entres dans la dimension spirituelle.
It's an access.
C'est un accès
in the spiritual dimension.
Dans la dimension spirituelle.
It's a contact.
C'est un contact
to spiritual dimension.
Au niveau spirituel. À la dimension spirituelle.
Because when somebody masturbates.
Parce que quand quelqu'un utilise la masturbation,
access the world of fantasy.
Quand il se masturbe, il entre dans le monde du fantasme.
You begin to fantasize.
Alors, tu commences à voir des fantasmes.
Until you get satisfied.
Genre jusqu'à ce que tu es satisfait.
And the Bible says.
Et la Bible dit.
We have the access.
Nous avons l'accès.
To bring in existence.
Pour appeler à l'existence.
The things.
Les choses.
That doesn't exist.
Qui n'existent pas.
So when you are in masturbation.
Si quand on sort de continuer masturbation.
Spiritually.
Na kolobana nenga molimo.
You access a force. There is a spirit that access and satisfies you.
Désolé mon limo mon que vous allez cocotte après qu'on passe un plaisir.
Because you imagine things that are not there.
Parce que vous allez cocaliser qu'on imagine bien quoi est-ce qu'on existe.
And that is not godly.
Et oh Isaiah bonzambeti.
It's a satanic covenant.
Is that satanic? Is that alliance satanic?
And that's why many people.
Yamo na bato mingi.
Who are in masturbation.
Oh vous allez la masturbation.
They cannot stop.
Bako koka kako suki se yamote.
They cannot say I stopped
because
it is as if there is a higher power.
Parce que ils ont encore la puissance moko supérieure plus forte que bango.
That pushes you.
Ils allaient pousser you.
What I say by today.
Nazali koloba lelo.
By today.
Kobanda lelo.
By the revelation of the Holy Ghost.
Par la révélation du Saint-Esprit.
Whoever was struggling with that.
Quiconque lutte avec la masturbation.
Let the power of the Holy Ghost.
Puissance du Saint-Esprit.
The fire of the Holy Spirit.
Le feu du Saint-Esprit.
To bring separation.
Puisse apporter
la
séparation. Dans le monde spirituel.
We have to break it. We have to disconnect with it. The same hands. You say it is holy. You lift that to the Lord. You come to church. You lift your hands. Holy,
holy.
These hands has become defiled. That's why Isaiah 59.
C'est pourquoi Isaïe 59.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
Because of your sin and iniquity, it has separated you with God. And your hands.
Et puis ma boko na bino.
Is filthy.
Et la salité.
So God cannot take your worship.
Nzambe akokondima masanjoli na bino te.
The Lord said that is another problem in the church.
Le Seigneur m'a dit, c'est ça aussi un autre problème dans l'église.
People say no, it is just normal.
Alors, les gens disent que non, mais c'est normal.
It is not normal.
Non, non, ce n'est pas normal.
It is a satanic access.
C'est un accès satanique.
Another access the Lord said.
Un autre accès que le Seigneur m'a montré.
Many people come to church.
Beaucoup de gens viennent bien à l'église.
But they have in their house.
Et bien, ils ont dans leur maison.
In their iPads.
Dans leur iPad.
In their phone.
Dans leur téléphone.
They have porno.
Ils ont des films et des images pornographiques.
They have DVDs in the house.
Ils ont des DVD dans leur maison.
Listen what the Lord said to me.
Écoutez ce que le Seigneur m'a dit.
He said, even if you are married,
il m'a dit, même si vous êtes bien marié,
some people say, no, I'm married.
Certains disent, oh, oui, je suis marié.
It's fine.
Et ça, ma l'amour.
It's not fine.
Non, et ça, ma paix.
It's a sin.
Et ça, les soumous.
It's an open door.
Et ça, porte fumoli.
To satanic spirits.
Mon ami, lis-moi, Satana.
And soon or later,
et l'autonomie,
it will fight you.
Marriage.
Because the Bible says,
la Bible dit,
that marriage is between two people who are, that relationship is between married people.
La relation c'est entre les gens qui sont mariés.
Now, if you have to be satisfied in your marriage,
si tu veux être satisfait dans ton mariage,
if the satisfaction in your marriage,
si la satisfaction dans ton mariage,
it comes by watching. These movies.
Bien, en regardant les films pornographiques.
Do you know that the people who do these movies?
Tu sais que les gens qui tournent ces acteurs là des films pornographiques.
They are not married.
Ils ne sont pas mariés.
So you need somebody to commit sin for you to be satisfied. It's not God.
Olivi mutu mususa sala lisumu poyo osepela oyezabunda.
Because what they are doing in the movie.
Oh, bazali kosala na film wana.
It's a sin. Because they are not married. It doesn't please the Lord.
So
how do you have to watch other people sinning for you to be satisfied? It's an open door. And we keep those DVDs in the house. You keep in your phone. You keep in under your bed. You are having satanic presence in your house. You know, sometimes we come to church, we pray, and then we build an altar that we put our offering and seed. But in your house, you have presence of the devil.
Presence
of
Satan.
You carry those DVDs. Some of you, even in your house,
même dans leur maison,
you have whiskey.
Tu as des boissons, le whiskey par exemple.
Jack Daniels.
On a mélangé 20 litres de Jack Daniels.
You see what Jack Daniels wanted to do to my son?
On est Jack Daniels, sali nini na mwana nangai.
He wanted to destroy him.
Ezalaki po ebebi sayi.
But you keep those things in your house.
You 5 litres de Jack Daniels na ndaku na yo.
You say it's for decoration.
Oh, ti pour la décoration kaka papa.
How can you decorate Satan in your house?
Ndenga nino ko yoko tete kavasa Satan na ndaku na yo.
Satan become a decoration in your house.
Satan comme décoration na ndaku na yo.
And that's why.
C'est pourquoi
there is no peace.
Ce n'y a pas de paix.
Soon or later, your children, because of that decoration, they will start using it. And
then
it's no more decoration. Am I helping somebody? Am I helping somebody? Listen to me. There is so many access that we give in our life. We are giving those access to the enemy. And then we are praying, we are fasting. But nothing is moving. Nothing is happening. You come to church, but you have double life. Double life. In the church,
l'église,
we know
to yebi,
you're single.
Oh yes, that's célibataire.
But out there,
libanda kuna,
you live another life.
Ozana bomoi mususu.
And now you come to church.
Tango ye ecclesia.
You think, oh, I need the anointing.
Kolona lingi onction spécial.
Which anointing?
Quel onction spécial tu veux, ma sœur?
We need to get right with God.
Nous devons être droit avec Dieu.
I say we need to get right
nous
with God.
Être en bonne position avec Dieu.
This is the only way that the Lord will bless you.
Ça, c'est le seul moyen que l'Éternel peut bien te bénir.
And this is the only way.
C'est le seul, la seule façon.
You will keep Satan out of your house.
Que tu peux avoir Satan hors de ta maison.
You will keep Satan out of your marriage.
Tu peux avoir Satan hors de ton mariage.
You come to church.
Tu viens à l'église.
But you're living with another man's husband.
Mais yo, zali kofanda na mubali ya mwasi mususu.
They give you 200 pounds.
Ba pesho 200 livres.
To pay insurance.
Pour faire assurance na yo.
300 pounds.
300 livres.
It makes you happy.
You want to see Billy.
But you are blocking your life.
Mais zali ko bloquer bo moyi na yo.
Because when you go with somebody's husband.
Parce que soko bimi na mwasi mubali ya mutu mususu.
The wife is crying.
La femme légitime à la maison est en train de pleurer.
So when is my husband?
You
are enjoying.
You mistress de tombanda bozo sepela.
But the wife is crying.
Mwa sinona nda kukuna papa zawapi.
Tears.
Golela na ye
pinzo. That woman.
Oya mwa sio nda ku.
It will block your life.
Eko bloke bo moyi na yo.
Amen.
Because Jehovah God,
parce que Jehovah Dieu,
he will avenge that woman.
Ako venge moi sur atikeli na ndako.
I say he will avenge that woman.
Ako venge moi sur zana ndako.
So it is the season now.
So c'est la saison maintenant.
To put our life right with God.
Pour nous d'être avoir notre vie en ordre.
To put back in alignment with God.
Bisoto zonga na alima na nzambe.
Listen to this.
Yo kabo.
The Bible says this. Papa.
La Bible dit ceci.
Papa Willie, the Bible says.
But, Willie, the Bible says this. The Bible says this.
The angel of the Lord.
L'ange de l'Éternel.
He came around.
Ayaka kunzinga zinga.
Of.
Yabai oyo bazaliko bahata.
He came around those who pray a lot.
Ayaka tena zinga zinga ba oyo ba ponde la kamingi tete.
Those who fast a lot.
Bato ba kila kamingi tete.
Those who big give big offering.
Bato ba pesa kama bonza ebele. No no.
The angel of the Lord.
L'ange de l'Éternel.
He came around.
Et came encore et aux entours
of those that fear the Lord.
Ceux qui craignent l'Éternel.
And listen.
Écoutez.
He are take them out of danger. Listen to me. There are some certain protection. Because the Bible says.
Parce que la Bible dit.
He take them out of danger.
Il les arrache du danger.
There are some certain protection.
Il y a certaines protections
that you can receive in your life.
Que tu peux avoir dans ta vie.
Without prayer.
Sans la prière. Alléluia.
Can I preach like a
je peux prêcher comme je le veux.
There are some protection.
Protection.
There are some supernatural covering.
Enveloppe supernaturelle.
Without prayer. Without fasting. You just sit. And danger is coming.
Danger
is coming. When the danger comes. It look at you. It see you. Wearing your white garment.
Of purity,
of holiness, of sanctification,
sanctification,
the holiness of God,
la sainteté de Dieu,
it will protect you.
La Bible dit,
in the book of Zechariah,
dans le livre de Zacharie,
the Bible says,
la Bible dit,
in the vision of the Lord,
dans la vision de l'Éternel,
Zacharie, he saw,
a vu,
Joshua the high priest,
Josué le sacrificateur, le souverain sacrificateur,
he was clothed,
à l'attaqué,
filthy garments,
à l'attaqué de la main salité,
and he was standing before the Lord.
Et atelemakiri bosona nkolonza.
With filthy garments.
Na bila mane ya salité.
And the Bible says.
Et la Bible dit.
Satan.
Le diable.
He was beside him.
Atelemakiri pene na ye.
Accusing him.
Funda kaye.
Before the Lord.
Et pa na nzambe.
There are some people.
Ezana bato mosusu.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
Joshua.
Josué.
The high priest.
Le souverain sacrificateur.
Joshua the high priest.
Josué le souverain sacrificateur.
The image of servants of God.
L'image de serviteurs de Dieu.
The image of the church.
L'image de l'église.
There are some pastors.
Il y a certains pasteurs.
There are some apostles.
Il y a certains apôtres.
Prophets and bishops.
Certains prophètes et les bishops.
your destiny before God.
Ils se tiennent devant Dieu.
They serve the Lord.
Ils veulent servir Dieu.
But their garment is filthy.
Et sa saleté.
When you find pastors,
quand vous allez voir pasteur,
with divorce,
n'avait divorce,
second wife,
deuxième femme,
oh, wife of the ministry,
oh moi si on attend la yeka kapona lotomo,
wife of the ministry does not exist,
moi c'est lotomo azalagate,
you have one wife,
sana moi si bon moko,
oh, mama ndaku.
My wife, the one that he use at home.
My wife doesn't like that language.
Ma femme n'aime pas tel langage.
Oh, ça c'est madame de la ma femme de la maison.
That's my legitimate wife.
I want to demand tu as la maison, tu as la femme de bureau, la femme de voiture, la femme de ministre.
You have a wife.
You have either is your wife not wife from the house?
She's your wife.
No,
not wife of the house or wife of the car.
No, filthy garments.
Les habits très sales.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
He stood before God.
Ils se sont tenus devant le Seigneur.
But his garments.
Il était devant le Seigneur, mais l'habit, le roi, la robe.
It was filthy.
Était sale.
And Satan.
Et le diable.
Was there.
S'était mis là.
To accuse him.
Pour l'accuser.
Many people you come to church.
Beaucoup de gens vous venez à l'église.
But your garment is filthy.
Mais ta robe, ton habit est très sale.
And Satan is there.
Et le diable est là près de toi.
To accuse you.
T'accusons.
If you read that verse.
Et si tu lis ce verset.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
Now the angel of the Lord said.
Maintenant l'ange l'Éternel a dit.
He said, remove the filthy garment from Joshua.
Enlève cet habit sale que Joshua porte.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
When they remove the filthy garment.
Quand ils ont enlevé cet habit là qui était sale.
Never ever in that chapter.
Jamais plus jamais dans ce chapitre.
They talk about Satan.
Ils ont parlé du diable.
Oh my God. Get what I said.
Parce que vous avez compris ce que
when the filthy garment was removed.
Quand l'habit qui était sale a été enlevé.
Satan was not more
le
blessed.
Diable n'était plus là.
He was never mentioned anymore.
On n'a plus parlé du diable.
Because the only thing that brought Satan there,
la seule chose qui a porté Satan près de Joshua,
it was the garment.
C'était cet habit là qui était sale.
And that's why Jesus said.
C'est pourquoi Jésus dit.
Satan came to me.
Le diable est venu vers moi.
But he finds nothing.
Il est venu vers moi mais n'a rien trouvé de
when they come to you,
quand il vient en toi,
they find gossip.
Il voit kotonga bamona kotonga na monoko na yo.
Everything that happened in Tottenham.
Hello, God knows the legacy that Tottenham made in the Finsbury Park.
You know. You know about that.
Yo yebi makamunioso.
You have become news giver.
Yo koma BBC 5.
BBC 5, huh? Give the Lord a clap of praise. Somebody give the Lord.
Can someone give a round of applause? That's the look of my applause.
Listen to me, church.
Écoutez-moi, église.
These are the things.
Oh, is that biloko oyo?
That is stopping us to break through.
Oh, is that ni kobloke biso poto zo perse na biso?
It is very simple.
Is that vraiment très simple?
Put your life right with God.
Diabo mo ina yon alima.
So that the devil will have no access.
Oye mo yimi akozala na tanga ko pusa na lisusute.
Because the things you say,
parce que les choses dont les choses tu dis
about other people,
à propos d'autres personnes,
about the church,
à propos de l'église,
these things are affecting you.
Biloko oyo ezali ko affecter you.
I said these things are affecting.
Ezali ko biloko ezali ko affecter bino.
Because these things,
parce que ces choses,
it removes the covering from you.
Ezali ko longola enveloppe ebate la kayo.
There are some people you come to church.
But mingi oyero na eglise.
You are part of Mangembo.
Oza membre eglise ya Mangembo.
But you speak bad about the church.
Bakasi olobaka mabe. Se mabe eglise na yo moko.
When you are speaking bad about the church.
Tango zoloba mabe ya eglise.
You speaking bad about the man of God.
Ozoloba mabe ya tatana ndako ange.
About the woman of God.
Ozoloba mabe ya mama na ndako.
About other pastors from Mangembo.
Ozoloba mabe ya ba pasteur mususu eglise ya Mangembo.
These things.
Biloko oyo.
Blocks your life.
Ezali ko bloke bo moyi na yo.
Let me show you something.
Diga na like sabino e logo mo.
Open the. Did I open the Bible already? Okay, go to Hebrews chapter.
Togena livre ya ba ebelo.
Somebody say praise the Lord.
Louons le Seigneur.
Is somebody be blessed today?
Est-ce que quelqu'un est béni aujourd'hui?
Go with me very quickly.
Allez-y avec moi rapidement.
Hebrews chapter 13 verse 17.
Hébreux 13 chapitre 17.
If you have a Bible, mark this verse.
Si vous avez la Bible, soulignez ce verset.
Mark, I want you to mark this verse.
Je veux bien que vous souligniez très très bien ce verset. Hébreux 13 verset 17. Yes.
Hebrews chapter 13.
Hébreux 13.
If you have a Bible, mark it. Mark it in your Bible, your iPad, mark that verse.
Hébreux 13. Verset 17, je lis au nom de Jésus. Obéissez à vos conducteurs et ayez pour eux de la déférence, car ils veillent sur vos âmes, comme devant en rendre compte qu'il en soit ainsi, afin qu'ils le fassent avec joie et non en gémissant, ce qui ne vous serait d'aucun avantage.
Ok, amen. Repeat that again, papa. The Bible says this, read with me. It says this.
La Bible dit ceci.
Obey those who are leading you.
Obéissez à vos conducteurs.
And be submissive, which means respect them. Submissive, obedience.
Ayez pour eux de la déférence, obéissez à vos conducteurs.
Because they are the ones that watches over you.
Car ils veillent sur vos âmes.
Listen to this.
Écoutez ceci.
They watch over your soul.
Ils veillent sur vos âmes.
You see the way you are sitting there.
Tu comprends quand vous êtes assis là.
There is somebody.
Il y a quelqu'un
who is watching over your soul.
Il veille sur votre âme.
Even if you are 15.
Et même si tu as 50 ans.
Even if you are 70.
Même si tu as 70 ans.
God put a leader in front of you.
Dieu a mis un leader devant toi.
Who is covering your soul?
Qui couvre, qui garde, qui veille sur ton âme.
Look at the person next to you.
Regarde ton voisin qui est près de toi.
Say, do you have this spiritual covering?
Est-ce que tu as cette couverture spirituelle?
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
Because He watches over you.
Il veille sur vos âmes.
I want to understand this with you.
Je veux que nous puissions comprendre ceci ensemble. J'ai une question.
Who is watching over you here?
Nani azali ko veye sur biso aw?
No, no. In this Bible, who?
Dans la Bible.
Is it God?
Est-ce que c'est Dieu?
Is it the Holy Spirit?
Est-ce que c'est le Saint-Esprit?
You know, some people say, oh, moi j'ai pas besoin d'un pasteur. Moi j'ai pas besoin d'un couvertier spirituel. C'est l'Éternel qui me garde. Non.
Protecting me, no.
Ça c'est pas. L'Ancien Testament, n'est-ce pas?
That's not the Old Testament, is it?
People who talk like that, they have the seed of rebellion.
Bato baloba kabo bazana mbuma ya rebellion.
Because here, this is New Testament.
Awa ezali Nouveau Testament.
The Bible says, because God placed leaders.
La Bible dit que Dieu a placé des leaders.
And the Bible says.
Et la Bible dit.
That leader is watching over your soul.
Ce leader veille sur vos âmes.
And he will give an account to God.
Et il devra donner rendre compte à Dieu.
And what touched me is this.
Et ce qui m'a vraiment touché, c'est ceci.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
Let them do the work of God with joy.
Laissez-les faire le travail de Dieu avec joie.
And not with murmuring.
Et non en gémissant.
Listen, when your pastor.
Écoutez, quand ton pasteur.
When daddy is murmuring.
Quand le pasteur commence à murmurer.
The Bible says.
La Bible dit.
Let them do the work with joy, not with grief, for that will be unprofitable.
Afin qu'il le fasse avec joie et non en gémissant, ce qui ne vous sera d'aucun avantage.
You see that?
Est-ce que vous le voyez?
You are working hard.
Tu travailles dur.
No benefits.
Il n'y a pas de bénéfice.
You work hard.
Tu travailles dur.
Nothing is moving.
Et rien ne marche.
Because secretly.
Parce que en secret.
You make your spiritual covering murmur.
Vous êtes en coucou, vous allez couper le mabé. Y a tata na yo.
Never let your spiritual covering murmur.
Jamais kotika couverture spirituelle na yo kuyo le mabé pour na yango.
It will block you.
Koti pour être bloqué.
The Bible says it will be of no advantage for you.
Cela ne sera d'aucun avantage pour vous.
You come to church.
Tu viens à l'église.
But you murmur about the church.
Mais tu gémis à propos de l'église.
You come to church.
Tu viens à l'église.
You murmur about the
pastors.
You go outside.
Okay, Libanda.
People are murmuring about the church.
But
and you come there. You come with. Listen.
Yoka.
These are the problems.
Yamonde makambo.
It removes spiritual covering.
La couverture spirituelle.
I was shocked for something I read in the Bible.
Ki choqué na
the Bible says.
La Bible dit.
One day.
Samuel,
he spoke to Saul.
Alobi na Saul.
He gave him again instructions.
Lisusu apesa ki instruction.
And Saul did not follow the instruction carefully.
Saul atosa ki instruction malamu penzati.
And when Samuel came,
et tamu Samuel aye,
he said to him,
Alobi na Saul,
the Lord has taken your kingdom.
Nzambe alongoli bokonzi likolo na yo.
And then he ripped the garment.
And the Bible says,
listen to this, an evil spirit,
un esprit mauvais,
coming from God,
venant de Dieu,
was tormenting Saul.
Et il y a que tourmenté Saul.
That verse tormented me.
Et verset Oyo, et ça l'a passé.
Because I asked question.
Pose
la question. I said that means God has evil spirit.
La mitunita me pas en milimo mabaya tinaka.
Are we together? I said, how does the Bible say that evil spirit coming from the Lord?
Nini pena Bible leko baki mulimo mabe uti vya ngolo.
And the spirit of God began to enlighten me.
Eh mulimo na nzamba fungula kinga
mabe. I said, because Saul had a covering of Samuel.
Yeah, Samuel.
And because of that covering, that covering, it was pushing away that no evil spirit could attract him. It was the covering of
Samuel.
When the covering was removed, those evil spirits now had access to him. I pray that you may be restored in your spiritual covering. I pray that your covering might be restored. Listen to me, church. What is it that I want to minister to you today? Is that there are some points that the Lord is saying to me to tell you to put back in alignment. Put your life back in alignment. Put your bad life back in alignment. There are some certain things you have to separate from. It is worthless to come to church and you are living a double life. It is worthless, you will be praying, fasting, but nothing is moving. We are in the declaration of war. But when you are in the war, you have to fight according to the rules of the war. That is arranging your life first. So that when we're going to engage into fasting and prayer, things are going to break loose. The devil will not be able to hold you.
Le diable ne sera plus puissant pour te retenir.
Your family shall be untouchable.
Ta famille deviendra intouchable.
Your finances shall increase.
Tes finances seront accrues.
Your business shall succeed.
Et ton business va réussir.
The favor of God will rest upon
la faveur
you.
De Dieu résidera sur
and
toi.
When the favor of God is upon
et quand
you,
la faveur de Dieu est sur toi,
everything shall become easy.
Tout deviendra facile.
I say everything shall become easy.
Tout deviendra facile.
Because the favor of God,
et la faveur de Dieu,
make it everything easy.
Et fait que toute chose devienne facile.
I say the favor of God,
j'ai dit la faveur de Dieu,
it make everything
et
become easy. Because
lui.
The favor of God,
parce que la faveur de Dieu,
it will bring you
et comme mayo,
when education cannot bring
si quand que là, c'est que comme mayo,
the favor of God,
nzambe,
it will bring you
et
where your family name could not
et
bring
si
you.
Comme ya famille, yo, et
the favor of God, it shall make you what nobody in London could make. That is the reason we have to put our life in alignment. Separate with stop living in a
thought.
Double life. Because I hear the sound. I hear the sound of the abundance. Of the rain of God.
Oh, la présence de Dieu.
Of the favor of God.
Oh, la bénédiction de faveur.
I prophesy over the church. I prophesy over you. That's the rain of God.
La pluie de Dieu.
The rain of His blessings.
La bénédiction de Dieu.
The rain of His favor.
La présence de Dieu. La bénédiction de Dieu.
Rain. The rain.
La rain. La pluie de
the rain of His favor.
La pluie de sa faveur.
The rain of His mercy.
La pluie de sa faveur.
The rain of His mercy. mercy.
La reine, la pluie de son, de sa miséricorde.
The rain of his glory.
La pluie de sa gloire.
Is about to fall upon this house. Let everybody stand very quiet. And just close your eyes as you stand.
Tukoyo kangimi sura ndemo zalikotelema.
We need you. We need your presence. We need you. Holy Spirit, fill this room. Holy Spirit. Everybody close your eyes. Everybody, your eyes closed. You have heard the voice of the Lord today.
Tu as écouté la voix de Dieu aujourd'hui.
The Lord came to restore.
Le Seigneur est venu restaurer.
You have acknowledged the open doors in your life.
Tu as reconnu les portes, les accès dans ta vie.
You say tonight,
et tu te dis cet après-midi,
I am ready to receive and walk in the abundance of God.
Je suis prêt à recevoir et à marcher dans l'abondance de Dieu.
And I want to arrange my life.
Et je veux réparer, fixer ma vie.
Come in the front. I want to pray with you.
Je veux prier pour toi. Tu peux venir ici devant.
Come very quickly. Don't be ashamed. Everybody, your eyes closed.
Tout le monde, ayons nos yeux fermés.
Keep your eyes closed.
Ayons nos yeux fermés.
Just come and kneel down. You are living a double life. You realize the open doors in your life. And tonight you say, man of God, it's my time to arrange with God.
Et le rapport que vous avez avec Dieu, mais allez tellement en gai na bongi sa bomo ina gai liboso nanza.
Come very quickly, come.
Yakambango.
Advance, kneel down before the Lord. Maybe you are a father. Everybody, close your eyes. Don't look at who is going and who is not. Jehovah Adonai is here.
Jehovah Adonai is here.
This is the word the Lord brought for you tonight.
Today.
That you can return to the Lord. That you can return to the Lord. You are living a double life. Come, the Lord is calling you. You have opened doors. Don't hold back. Come right now. God wants to forgive you and restore you. I came for restoration this morning. I came for restoration. That there will be no access anymore. Now begin to repent before the Lord. Listen, don't just come to come. But take a decision inside us. And say, Lord, tonight I want to live. I want my life to be changed.